So coming back to here, you have your static pressure,
dynamic pressure, hydrostatic pressure, and total pressure.
You remember this, yeah? The key is just using this. Sometimes you need to use manometer. Okay. Now we will test you. Not individually, but in a group. What happens if I put one in here, in this location?
You have to include the pressure of the water.
And? And velocity. Because here, the water starts to move. On top, if it is very large reservoir, V, the movement of going up and down will be zero. Negligible.
Meaning
it's negligible, but it is there. If you have a bottle of water, then you puncture using a needle, you know, your friend needle, they usually use udong, right? Udong, some udong, right? Needles, you know. Needle, lot of needle. My wife use a lot of needles, so I cannot do anything if I accept her. You can take one and do that. Right, so if you puncture it, it will go down, literally, but very slow. Uh-huh. Which means your velocity is close to zero, not zero, close to zero. Okay, that's why you get, like what? What is this? This one is wrong. Noodle equal to. Curly equal to. Okay, and then YP2 is equal to zero, atmospheric. After that, you feel the pressure, right? When you pull it, you feel the pressure, right? Mm. You got a tank, you open the tank, then you put your hand there, you feel the pressure, right? Why is this atmospheric pressure? Then what is this pressure?
Water pressure.
Water pressure. Where does this pressure come from? Because the water is moving and you stop it. That's why you feel the pressure. So that pressure is actually stagnation pressure. But the static pressure on that location is equal to atmospheric. Why? Because at the same depth, same liquid, pressure has to be the same again. So from here, the pressure is atmospheric pressure, inside also atmospheric pressure. Look like here. Where? 2 more minutes. Okay, so that's why you got your P2 equal to atmospheric pressure. This is not P2 equal to zero, yeah? Zero gauge. Now remember, when I put gauge, it means it is atmospheric pressure. Okay? Any question? Please? Okay, no. But now the problem is, for free gas, there is the so-called Fenner contractor effect. What this about is the shape of the outlet will then define how big is it. Okay, when you puncture a hole, the water will not be as big as the hole size. It will be smaller or same. It will never be bigger. It will be smaller or the same, depending upon the opening. So you can see that this is how it's open. Contraction coefficient is a gap divided by a hole. This will be important for group 3. You remember your group 3? Group 3, we do not that Fenner contractor effect into account. That's why you got A2, V2 equal to A1, V1. This basically is not true. Because these things you have to put CC, contract coefficient. Okay, so that one. Okay, so for question, example number 2 and number 3 is about the same. You will use this, right? You will use the mass flow rate and the Bernoulli equation. So for the case of this, you will put a pressure over here and pressure meter over here. You will do this on experiment 4 in our experiment. Experiment 4 and experiment is positive. So you measure here and there. How to do that? You make a hole, you measure the pressure. You make a hole here, you measure the pressure. So you will know your pressure 1 and pressure
2.
Pressure 1 and pressure 2 is known. V1 and V2 can be relayed using this. So you have only one, because A1, V1 equal to A2, V2. So basically V2 is equal to A2 over A1, V1.
Hey, A2, V2.
Like in here. Okay, is that clear? Okay, that is clear. The other thing, we will explain on Monday. Next Monday. Before your mid exam, hopefully still got time. So we will explain that, and then in the afternoon we will have our mid exam. Or you want to? I'm thinking to
postpone.
If we postpone on Wednesday, then we will stick with that. So Monday we will just do the so-called kind of tutorial for the Bernoulli equation. Okay, Monday we will just do Bernoulli equation tutorial. So we will solve all this problem. Okay, because we haven't solved this problem, right? Actually, this is part of group two. And this one is part of group one.